Hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Again, this is Mr. Santos Capilan Jr., always wishing you a good day. Now today, what I'm going to do is to continue my series of tutorial for how are you going to create a BMS graphics. Now, in my last tutorial, I already completed. So this is my completed BMS graphics for water tank level management system. Okay. Now, today, what I'm going to do is to show you how I'm going to bind. There is a binding for BMS graphics to physical devices or motor control. Now, as you know, I have here two pumps. Now, when there is a pump and there is a motor, there will be always a motor control. Okay. Now, this motor control will be the one to give us the real-time value for the monitoring points like manual handoff auto status or run trip of the two pumps. Now, for the physical, for the field devices, we have field devices like this differential pressure transducer for each tank. So this is the differential pressure transducer. Okay. So now, if you want to know how you are going to wire and how are you going to connect your BMS field devices, you have to go to my channel and look for the tutorial in field devices, BMS field devices connection and wiring. Okay. Now, today what I'm going to do is to do the binding, okay? So meaning when I say binding, my graphics should be binded where it will get the physical or the actual or the real-time value from the field, okay? Now here, I'm using here my automation server, okay? So this is my automation server, okay? This is a very powerful controller, okay? Now, because this is also a server where it can communicate to BACnet controllers or LON controllers, okay? Now, this automation server can communicate to BACnet controllers, okay? Now, this automation server, I can connect here several input and output modules. So what I have here is an analog output module, digital output module, UI8A04, combination of universal input and analog output, then combination of universal input and digital output. Then I have here purely UI16, meaning I can connect 16 monitoring points, but this is universal inputs. Okay, so when you say universal input, it could be counter input, digital input, voltage input, current input, resistive input, and so on. Okay, now first, before I will do the actual binding, let me show you first my this IO module. Okay, let me edit it in spreadsheet to show you, because the control panel in the field or the field devices will be connected to our IO modules. Okay, now I have here several points like handoff auto status, pump one, run and trip, handoff auto, run trip for pump two. Now, these points will be coming from the motor control of these two pumps, okay? So, meaning from the motor control, there will be BMS cables pulled to that control panel. Then there will be BMS points provision. When I say BMS points provision, the fabricator of the control panel, they will be asked by the BMS engineer, okay, you have to provide me these several points in your panel, like handoff auto, run, and trip. Okay, so trip will be coming from the overload protection of the motor. Then run can come from the auxiliary contact of the contactor for its pump. Okay, so from that motor control, there will be BMS provision points where you will connect the cable. From that point, it will go to the IO module. Okay, so that control panel will give the signal, go to the IO module. Then our my controller automation server will try to get the value, the real-time value from this IO module. IO module will get the value from the controller or the field devices, okay? So I think it will be clear. Now here, I have here universal 16. So meaning I have 16 channel here, okay? So one channel will be associated with one physical device, okay? So I think if you want to learn more about this points creation, you have to go over my tutorials. Okay, now here I will just give you an example here. So this channel one, input one, I define it digital input. Then this is the points definition. Okay, now this is the name of the point. Now for the name, you have to make a descriptive name. It's just like programming. You have to define a variable name or an identifier name. Okay, so it should be unique. Then you can always put an optional description. Okay, now this description will help the next engineer that will try to maintain your program so that he will be able to know what are these points. Okay, so these are the points. I have also some points here in my another module. So let me show you here. Okay, so my pump one start, I will be getting here. Okay, now for the differential pressure transmitter, I will be getting the value from this analog output module. As you can see here, I have the final settling tank differential pressure or differential pressure transducer sensor. Okay, so I have here 6. Okay, now so let's ask. Okay, let me close these things so it will not. Okay, now let me begin the bindings. Okay, so when you say binding, we will bind the graphics where it will get the real-time value in the field. When we say field, from the field device or from the motor control panel. Okay, so I will come here, then I will right click, then I will say edit bindings. Okay, now in the edit bindings window, it will display all the points that we define in the graphics. If you remember, when I created the graphics, we have created the several snippets or the dynamic text or dynamic value. So most of it are dynamic text. Okay, so these are the one that we define there. Okay, so this one, let's say domestic tank one level. So this is the differential pressure sensor for domestic water tank number one. Okay, now these are the points in my graphics. Okay, the dynamic text or the dynamic value from my graphics. Then I have to bind it here in the right side. I have to look for my where is it connected. Now, as you know, this transducer, I defined it in my analog output module. Okay, so it will be here. So domestic water tank one. So domestic water tank one. Okay, so I have to click and drag it here. So meaning this dynamic text or this dynamic value will get the value from this analog output module, wherein this analog output module is connected through wire to the differential pressure transmitter installed in the domestic water tank. Okay, so that is binding. So from graphics dynamic value, then it will be binded to the analog output module where I define the domestic water tank differential pressure transducer. Then from this analog output module, there will be one cable, DMS cable, to core connected to the differential pressure transducer installed in the domestic water tank one. So you see now the flow of information from the field device. There will be cable connected to it. It will go to my IO module. Then from IO module, it will be connected to my IO bus. Then my automation server where I defined my graphics. Then these graphics will get the value. Okay, so as I hope you have seen how the data will be pulled or how it will be retrieved from the field device. Okay, so let me continue. This is the okay, so this is command. Okay, so where I connected it, I think it's here. Okay, so this here, this is the domestic water tank solenoid valve command. Okay, so this one will be the one to give me the real-time value if the valve is being commanded to open and close. So this is the domestic tank two. Okay, well, so this is domestic tank two. Okay, so I'll bind it here. DMT water level, two water level. So it will be here. Okay, so this is the sensor. Then this one is the DW2 domestic water tank one. So what is this one? Okay. So I think I have changed the one. This is domestic water tank one. Domestic zone. Okay, so this one is this will be the one here. Okay, SB command. So this one, let me get this one. Okay, domestic water tank one. I think that is the different. You can always go and check your graphics. Okay, if you are not sure with the points. Okay, this one is domestic water tank. Okay, for the decrease. Okay, so this is will be the sensor level is sensor. Okay. Then domestic water tank zone above. Okay, here so domestic water tank two. I think that will be for domestic water differential sensor. Okay, domestic solenoid valve. Okay, domestic level domestic water tank. Okay, it will be here. Domestic water tank. Okay. FST final settling tank. Okay, where is my final settling SB command? FST level. Where are you? Okay, this one level. Likewise, it's also level here. Oh, FST SB command. Okay, so just click and drag FST water level. That is the level sensor. FWT1 fire water tank. Okay, that is fire water tank. That will be then SB command fire water tank. SB command. What else? Fire water tank level. Okay, fire water tank one. Okay, then fire water tank level. Okay, fire water tank one level. Okay, what else? FT level increase. Fire water tank one. Okay, no issue. Okay, SB command. Fire water tank one. SB command. Fire water tank two. Fire water tank two. That will be fire water tank two. This one. Then fire water tank 2 SB command, fire water tank 2 SB command, okay. Then fire water tank level, fire water tank 2 level, okay. Now let's go to the next page, okay. FW2 SB command, FW2 SB command, okay. So solenoid valve command, FW level, FW2 level, okay. Irrig, okay, irrig SB command, irrig SB command, okay. Irrig level, okay. Irrig level, okay. Irrig level, likewise here. Irrig SB command, okay. Because we have several the same bind in the graphics. Irrig SB command, okay. Irrig water level, irrig water level, irrigation water level, irrig water tank, okay. Irrig water tank. Pump one command. Okay, now I'm going to pump one command. Where is my pump one command? I think it's here. Okay, so this is my pump one command. Okay, pump one command. Okay, then pump feedback. So I will get it from my, where's my flow? Do I have flow here? No, it should be in the UI16. Okay, in my UI16. Okay, P1 water flow. P1 water flow, okay. Now let me go here. Okay, there's still some other P1 flow. Okay, so let's put this there. P1 flow, okay. P1 and the power status. P1 run hours, okay. I have not defined the run hours, so I will just P1 run status. Later I will bind it. P1 SS command. So my P1 SS command, it's here. P1 SS command. P1 trip. Where's my P1 trip? I think it's here. P1 trip. P2 command. Okay, P2 command will be here. Where is the P2 command? Okay, here. P2 command, okay, P2 feedback, I will use the flow status. Okay. Likewise here. Likewise here. P2 hand of auto status. P2 hand of auto status. Okay. So this is called bindings. Okay. P2 run hours is not yet defined. I will define it in my control logic program. Okay. P2 SS command. Okay. So my P2 SS command is here. Then P2 trip status. P2 trip status. Okay. P2 trip status. P2 trip status. Okay. P2 run status. P2 run status. Okay. Now I'm almost done. Pump flow status. Okay. Now that one I will define it later. Okay. Now once you define most of the points, okay, the next thing you need to do is save it. Okay. So I have already shown you how are you going to define, how are you going to do the binding. So I guess you already have an idea what is binding for. So binding is your dynamic text or your dynamic value in your graphics. Okay. So these things, okay. So these things, it will be binded to the I/O module where you connected the wire or the physical wire going to the control panel or the field devices. Okay, so I think it's already clear with you what is the purpose of binding. Okay, so as you can see here, now here, when you click it, you will see already the where it is binded. So this one is binded to P1 hand of auto status. So where is that point? So that one is coming from my reference. See, okay, so it's not shown here where it will come. Okay, anyway, so you will be here. So it will be shown here from input channel 1. Okay, so let me see if we can show you. Okay, so it's not shown here, but it will just show you the channel of the I/O module where it is connected. Okay, now like this up. Okay, so as you can see, it's already all the points are binded already. Most of the points are binded. Okay. So this one is already binded. Okay. So we will be doing some animation later. So okay. Now this one I have to play. I have some initial value here. I will change it so for the next part of this tutorial. Okay, guys. I think you already have now this one. There is no, this one is binded. This one is binded. This one is binded. This one is binded, this one is not binded. Okay, now this one is not binded. So let's go back here. That is final settling tank. I think I have seen one. Let me go back here. I think I have seen one level here. I think this is the one. Okay, so let me bind here. Let me see if that's the one. Okay, sometimes you should be very careful. Final, okay. So let's drop it here, there, then let's see if it's that's the one. Okay, so that's the one. Okay, so it will be binded in final settling tank differential pressure transducer sensor. Okay, so almost. Okay, now this one have some values already there. I will play with it later. Okay, now the next part of this tutorial or the part 7 will be testing of the graphics. Now I have shown you the binding. Next step is how we are going to simulate the control so that we will see the real-time value coming from the field. Okay, because let me see, because I have a motor control here. Let me see if we can. Now, okay, let me see why it's not showing any value there. Okay. Anyway, the next part of my tutorial will be how these monitoring points will change based on the real-time value in the field. Okay, now let me check the connection in the control panel so that I can simulate the changing of the dynamic text, okay, and the dynamic values. Okay, so again, I think this will be enough for this heartaches, and I do hope I have given you a clear idea how, why you have to bind the BMS graphics so that you will be able to see the real-time values from the control panel or from the field where you are monitoring the values, okay? So again, thank you very much. And again, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. And you can always click the notification bell. And you can always leave a comment if you have any query in your mind. And Santos Capilian Jr. is always saying God bless us all. Bye for now.